cosa di riportarlo in ordine.
So here we can see that it is an industrial PLC trainer. Model name is Expo PLC. So here we can see that there are various panels on this rack. First panel shows the SMPS power supply panel. Here you can see there are two sockets which gives us 230 volts AC. Here also there are two lines. This gives 230 volts external use. So here is a power on off switch, and here you get a 24 volt DC output. So the second panel shows the simulation extension panel for 8 digital inputs and 6 analog inputs and 2 analog outputs. So here you can see there are the input sockets over here, and the output analog outputs are there by using ports. Third one is our simulation panel, where we give the various SAPs. For example, you can connect process control panel. Second one, the tank level control. These are the various sample panels. There are another one is the 7-segment panel. Okay, here you can see the 7-segment is displayed with its truth table. Okay, there are many other panels like this. The fourth panel is a relay and simulation plus extension panel with 8 digital outputs. Other one is our PLC is of Siemens make, Semantic S7-1200 PLC, which has 30 digital input output panels, 26 digital output panels, 2 analog input panels and 2 digital analog output panels. The sixth one is analog input output panel AIO. Here you can see there are 4 analog inputs and 4 analog outputs. So here you can see there are 4 analog inputs with 4 analog outputs. The another one is the converter cum DI distribution panel CDP. Here there are digital inputs. See, here you can see the CDI, CD input. These are the input panel sockets. These are the digital output panels. So these are the common lines, where means example ground. Here is a 24 volts supply. The last one is our HMI, which is optional. Okay. Now we will see how to use the Semantic TIA software for writing any logic diagram or any program. First of all, you should install TIA portal in your PC. So first, after installing the software, go to the programs, all application programs. Here you can see TIA portal V14 version. So just you have to double click on this, so the software will open. See, it's in Siemens software. Okay, you can see a TIA portal. It's a totally integrated automation portal. Here you can write a project or a ladder diagram, connect this to your PLC, see the outputs. So various actions can be performed in this software. First of all, okay. Now what, first one, we will see the PLC description connection details. So for this, go to the project icon, click on this project, go to new project. Here and pop-up will occur naming, you have to create a new project. So you have to write any project name. For example, I am writing XYZ okay, this project I am going to write. You have to provide the path name or the path. For example, I am writing in D drive. You have to describe the D drive path. Okay. Give the extension. Okay. And X, Y, Z. Okay. You have to then click on create icon. A project with this name is already exist. Okay. You can change the name also. Is ABC. We will just replace this with ABC. You can write your own name also, any project name. Then you have to create this. It will create a project in that folder, D drive, ABC, ABC, ABC. So here you can see in this D drive, ABC, ABC project has been created. Now we have to add a new device, means we have to give the device name or the PLC name to this software. So here you can see there is a project tree. See here, there is a project tree over here. You have to click on add new device. You have to just double click on this. Okay, our is a controller part. So we have selecting controllers. Then we have to select Symantec S7-1200 because our PLC module is S7-1200 PLC. So we have to select that. Click on this cursor. Then you have to select the CPU. Okay, our model is CPU 1214 DC DC. See this one. CPU 1214 DC DC. You have to click this cursor. Then we have to select the model number 6ES7214 1AG. Okay, after selecting, click on OK icon. So here you can see our PLC has been our device has been appearing on this screen. Now we have to select the input output controlling parts. So you have to select on the second icon. So go in the options of catalog. In this you can see DI DQ because we are giving some input and we are taking some outputs. So you have to select this icon. In this we have 16 inputs, 24 volt DC DQ relay. DI 16 DQ 16 24 volt DC. We have to select this one. In this we have the model number is 6ES7-2231BQ. Okay, after selecting this, double click on this. Okay, we have been selecting our PLC as well as with the input output DIQ. Now we have to compile this and download this settings in our PC. So first of all, in this here you can see and compile option. See here there is a compile option. Just click on this. So the software is now compiling. After compiling, you have to download these settings. So just write to it. It's a download option, download to device. So the second part is how to power on this PLC trainer. We have given a mains cord. From this you can connect to the 230 volts connection. So there is a power on switch. Okay, using this switch you can power on this trainer. Okay, for powering on this trainer we have to give supply to this PLC. Supply to this PLC as well as supply to the relay simulation extension panel as well as this. And also we need an Ethernet cable. So here you can see it's an Ethernet cable connected back to of this PLC. Back to of this PLC there is an Ethernet connected behind this PLC and other part is given to our PC. So by this way we can connect PC to PLC using Ethernet cable. Now we will connect or give power on to this PLC. To power on this PLC you have to connect through patch cords.
So here is a patch cord. We are connecting through 20 volt output this one, and a ground to this one. So the supply will 24 volts we will give to this. Here you can see there are various 24 volt sockets on this distribution panel. So we are connecting on this, and ground will connect in the common part. Okay. So by this way our PLC will get on. So you can see I am power on in this switch. Okay. See there are LEDs glowing over there. So our PLC has been turned on. So by this way we can turn on the other panels as well. Now we will download our settings, PLC settings, as well as the input output settings which we have done earlier by downloading this option. So now you have to click the option download. So it will download these settings, the PLC device name and other settings into the software. So here is an extended download to device option. Now you can see that there is an PG/PC interface which is connected Realtek. No need to change anything from this. You have to keep as it is. Now in this you have to select show all compatible devices. Means it will show all the compatible devices with this PLC. So in this you have to select a start search. It will search all the compatible devices. So I'm clicking on this. So it will search all the compatible devices in its list. It will take some time to select. So here you can see there is an compatible device has been detected. Now you have to select this flash LED. By selecting this you can see it will flash the LEDs on the PLCs, means it will turn on and off these LEDs. So first of all when I click this option it will flash on and off for some time. See, it will be flashing. This means that our software PC and the PLC has been connected. So I will just untick this. Okay, now I will load this. See, here you can see the load option over here. So you have to select continue without any synchronization. You have to do some settings over here. You have to select this one and stop all. Okay, and then you have to click load. So these configurations are being loaded in the PLC. So we have to click on this finish icon. Now the PLC has been connected. Now we will write a new ladder or a simple on-off ladder by using this. So to write a new ladder you have to select on the program blocks. Here you can see the program blocks. You have to select on this cursor, then on main OB1 you have to double click on this. By this you will get an window where you have to write a ladder diagram. There are various icons over this. Here you can see. So first of all we will write a simple logic diagram or logic operations. So for writing any logic operations you have to select a bit logic operations. There are various other operations also, comparator operation, math operations, move operations, but we are writing only on and off which requires only bit. So we are selecting this bit. So there are various tick options here. First one shows the normally open contact, second shows a normally closed contact. There are various contacts and simple bit operation functions. So first of all we will select an normally open contact. Okay, we are just double click on. So here you can see a normally open contact has been created on the ladder. Second one we will show the output. Output can be assigned. So select on this or double click on this. See, here you got an output or assignment. First of all, we will assign there as an input and as an output. For assigning input, you have to double click on this question icon. You have to name this, for example, I, because it's an input, and 0.0 because it's in first position, zeroth position. Then enter two times, 1, 2. Okay, our 0.0 has been assigned onto tag 1. Second one, we have to assign it as an output. So as an output, we are assigning is that Q 0.0 and enter for two times. Okay, by this we have written a normal logic diagram. Okay, now we will compile this. Okay, so same procedure, you have to compile this. Compilation has been done. See here, zero errors and zero warnings have been detected, so no errors are there. Now we have to compile this, download to device. Okay, then click to load option. It will take some time to load the configurations. Okay, so to see the output on this window, there is an option. So here you can see the monitoring on and off icon. By this you can monitor your logical diagram or output on it. So this window will appear. See the ladder diagram. Now we will do the connections for this. Okay, now you have to connect the input, and to see the output on the relay, we have to connect these connections. So first of all, we will give the supply to this. So this is the 24 volt supply we are giving for the digital input outputs. So here, then we are connecting the ground from here to the common of this distribution panel. Another part is to connect the relay simulation extension panel, giving them the supply 24 volts here, and connecting its ground to common part from here to here. So by this means we are giving supply to all over this. Now the part is to connect the digital inputs. So we are just connecting one digital input, is CD/1 I/1, from here to the input switch. Okay, now the output part 0.1 to the relay. So we have done with the communication. Now what is this? We have to see the output. When I am pressing this switch, normally switch, open switch, see the connection has been connected. Okay, as well as you can see in the PLC also. See, after pressing this, the first zeroth part of the PLC will get connected, because I have written the diagram, logical diagram. You can see the same on this monitoring screen also. When I am pressing the switch, you see the ladder color changing. It turns to green color. It is now disconnected. If I am pressing this switch, it gets connected and the color gets changed. So this is the process of connecting the PLC. So in this part, we will see various static application panels we are going to run. There are 19 static application panels in which we are going to run a doorbell program. So for this, we have to every PLC panel we are giving a CD in which we will get all our sample programs. Now we will open an already made project. So in the options project, go to option open. In this, you have to browse your file. So for example, when you click on this browse file, we have in the D drive. So in this D drive, there is an option or a folder named SAP program. You have to double click. Okay,
there are various 19 different SAPs, 19 different static application panels. First one is doorbell, second one is switching of lights, and etc. So we will run our first program, doorbell. You have to double click on this. See, here you can see an Siemens TI portal project which is already been made by us. It's a sample. I have to double click on this. It says, do you want to save the changes? It depends on you. You have to save for this, yes or no. I'm selecting no. So our doorbell project will now be opened. So here you can see an PLC. Okay, in the program block, you have to just click this, which we have done for the last time. You have to double click on main this OB1 file. So here you can see our ready-made ladder diagram for doorbell. So in this, a gate switch has been provided and an door switch has been provided. When you connect a gate switch, your output will be turned on or off. Same with the door switch also. Now we will download this ladder diagram into our PLC. So you have to first compile this. So you have to click on the compile option. It will compile. So here you can see compile has been finished with zero error and zero warnings. Now you have to download this file into our PLC. So click on the download to device option. It is being downloaded. It will take some time. So it will ask for the options. You have to select on the delete all option. It will reset the module. And you have to click on load option. So it's loading all the configuration into the PLC. This will take us some time. So it's in start. You have to select this one and then click on finish. So our ladder program has been downloaded in the PLC. So if you want to see it, you can click on this monitoring option. Here you can see all this PLC, all these things get activated. Okay, here you can see this is monitoring simulator window. Now we are going to see we have done some connections of this doorbell SAP. These connections are being given in this manual. With every PLC trainer kit, we give a manual. In this manual, you can see there are 19 SAPs given over here. This is the first one, doorbell. So this is the manual. You can see expo PLC/SW. Okay, after opening this on the page number 3-10, you can see there are 19 SAPs. So we have connected the doorbell operation. There is a sequence of the task is given over here. We have to connect these things with table 3.53 connection chart for doorbell operations. Okay, you have to do these connections using these patch cords. So I have done this already. Now what I have done, my PLC program has already been downloaded in this PLC. Now I will run this. First of all, I will give the by pressing this switch, I can see the door switch gets on, gate switch. So see, after pressing this, gate switch gets activated, alarms get activated. Okay, because my code or the logic I have written is like this. The second one is the door switch.
1 second ke liye on ho gaya.
It will be on for 1 second only. See. Okay, so by this you can connect other SAPs over here. Using the logic diagram, download this, all the PLC logic diagrams using this portal to this PLC, and you can do the other SAPs using this manual logic diagram as well as with the wiring connections.